Hello everybody, Matt here, and welcome to episode 23 of my Fragrance Obsession. Now this is my second video of the day. It's about 9 o'clock in the morning. I woke up bright and early to do this, actually, because I felt like it would be fun. Now today's episode is a very kind of exciting one, again. Now before I start this, I would like to say a big thank you to the person that sold me this fragrance, Dalius. If you're watching this video, I would like to say thank you very much, all the way from Lithuania, for giving me this fragrance and of course giving me another bottle of Balenciaga Port Homme. So I now own two of those. Very, very happy to own that, and I'm also getting another one in a couple of days' time. So I'm like, this video goes out to him, and I just want to say a big thank you to him for selling me this fragrance, because this is another discontinued fragrance, and it's another miniature bottle that I own, and I'm very, very happy to own it. This is a one which I didn't know anything about, if I'm honest with you. I didn't know how it smelled, I didn't know anything about it at all, so it was a bit of a mystery. I heard about this fragrance on Base Notes. Now, I love Base Notes, I'm on there all the time, I love to see fragrances I've never heard of, and this was a one which I've known for about a year and a half, but I've never been able to find it because it's so difficult to track down. A little bit like Balenciaga Port Homme, that one's really difficult to find too. But it's possible if you find someone very good on eBay, like I have done with Dalius. You know, he's been very, very kind. So yeah, this fragrance goes back all the way to 1988. Now I can't really tell you when it was discontinued or anything, I don't know anything about that. Apart from, it was launched in 1988 and it's called, here we go, Furyo, released by the house of Jacques Bogart. Now this is actually the first Jacques Bogart fragrance I've actually reviewed. Now usually I would review something like One Man Show, which of course is still in production, and I actually have it in my collection, and I've wore that quite a lot, so I know exactly how it smells. But I thought I would review this one because it is a discontinued fragrance, and I wanted to kind of get it out of the way, you know, because it's discontinued and you can't get it anymore. Yeah, Furyo, it's a very distinctive fragrance. Now, this is probably the most oriental fragrance I've ever smelled before, because it's very strong, it's very pungent, and it's very kind of, it's quite weird, you know? But it smells good. It's a good smell, it's not a bad smell or anything, but it does have a weird kind of opening. I do like it very much, if I'm honest with you. Now, I've looked at reviews on this fragrance, and people have said that it's a masterpiece. You know, some people have said that it should never have been discontinued. You know, it's a delightful fragrance. It's so unique. It beats Kuros. It beats other strong powerhouse fragrances. Do I think it beats Kuros? Probably not, but it's still a good fragrance. Now, the one thing I love in the whole kind of fragrance industry is unique fragrances. Now, I own quite a lot of unique fragrances, one of them already being Balenciaga Port Homme. I don't think that's pretty much like anything. Well, it's a little bit like Lapidus Port Homme, but it's still unique. It still has that kind of unique blend, you know? And this is one of them. This is something that I don't really think smells like anything else, so I'm very, very happy to say that. Because, you know, you get a little bit sick of having fragrances and then finding out it smells like another fragrance which is in your collection. So that's annoying. But with Fuyro, it isn't like that. This is a completely different fragrance. Of course, with it being one of those like dab on bottles that you put on your skin, I've only smelt it like a tiny bit. So I'm going to try it again here. Here we go. Now, the juice is really, really dark. I don't know if you guys can see that. It's like a really dark brown. And what's weird is when you smell it, it's almost like the color is coming to life. You know, it's like, it smells very musky, it smells very woody. Straight off your skin, what you get is like a very faint lavender smell. Now, it's not like in your face, it's like in the back. And then, but what's weird is it's mixed with this kind of, what I like to think of it as more of a pine type of wood. And then after a while, I start to get cinnamon. And the cinnamon in this works very well, I think. Because, you know, you're getting the pine and the lavender, and then after a couple of seconds later, you're getting that cinnamon. And then all together, when it's all piled into one, it just creates this scent, which is on my hand. And it's very difficult to describe. See, it's actually starting to smell really nice now. I'm starting to get the woods more. I'm starting to get more of the pine coming in. Oh, I think it's pine anyway. I don't think pine's in the fragrance pyramid, but I'm detecting pine. So yeah, it's very decent. This isn't a groundbreaking fragrance, yet people have said that, you know, they think it's a masterpiece and everything. I don't think it's amazing, but I'm very, very happy to own it, simply because it is discontinued and it looks pretty cool. It looks like one of those little, it's like I've seen pictures of perfumers when they're testing out and they're making their own little fragrances and they have them in those little sample bottles. It looks like that. And it also looks like a medicine. All I'm going to say about Furyo, it's a very unusual but very classic fragrance that's very hard to find. So if you're wanting to get a bottle of this fragrance, try eBay, because eBay is your best bet. So guys, thank you very much for looking at this video. It means a great deal. I will be doing another review in a few days, and I promise I will be. I know there's been times I'm missing out weeks. This time it's been a month, but there's going to be no more of that, I promise. Even if I only do one a week, that'll probably be enough, I think. So, okay guys, thank you very much for watching this review. My name is Matt, and welcome? More like thank you for watching my fragrance obsession. See you later, guys. Bye.